dear brothers and sisters in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we are going to reflect today on the Bible verse, "You will not be forgotten." The Lord, who is kind and merciful, may open our inner eyes and ears, fill us with the power of His divine spirit and power, and make Himself present to each of us during this time of reflection and prayer. Amen. Hallelujah. In the book of Prophet Isaiah, chapter 49, verse 15, we read, "Can a woman forget her nursing child, or show no compassion for the child of her womb? Even these may forget, yet I will not forget you." What a loving, tender and energizing words, my dear people. Can anyone else in this world utter these gracious and most affectionate words to each of us? The world we live in is unstable and unsafe, so also our relationship with each other, our friends and relatives, and even our parents promise to be with us always, but the reality is they neglect us most of the times, abandon us, or forget us, and as a result of this, we tend to undergo a lot of suffering and pain in life. But we have a God who promised to be with us always and continues to stay with us in good and bad times, in darkness and light, as the sweet beloved of the soul. The prophet Isaiah had experienced so intensely this closeness and oneness of God, our Heavenly Father. And so he says in Isaiah chapter 49, verses 1 and 2, "The Lord called me before I was born. While I was in my mother's womb, He named me. He made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of His hand, He hid me. He made me a polished arrow. In His quiver, He hid me away." Yes, even before we were conceived in our mother's womb, He knew us. He called us by our name and continues to hide us in the shadow of His hands. Like a potter who shapes the pot, He molds and shapes us into precious beings day after day. What a great and unconditional love we experience from this God who never forgets us. Even the psalmist had experienced and expressed this constant and precious love of our Creator God in Psalm 103, verses 1 to 5. Let us all listen very attentively and prayerfully. "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and do not forget all His benefits, who forgives all your iniquity, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with steadfast love and mercy, who satisfies you with good as long as you live, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles." Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! My dear brothers and sisters, do we need any extra words to describe the love of our beloved Lord? When we falter, He comes to carry us in His arms. When we are in pain and suffering, He comes as a solace and consolation to lighten the burden. When we are in dark night of discomfort and loneliness, He, our loving Savior, is there to keep us safe in the shadow of His hands. He, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, is a God who can never forget us, for His very nature is love, and so we can rest safely, trusting in His most holy presence and goodness. Amen. We might find ourselves often living a life unworthy of His love and forget the sufferings He underwent for our sake and wander away from Him. Or we might also be undergoing hunger, pain, loneliness, anxiety, and suffer the fear of COVID-19. But we have a God who speaks to us like a friend to a friend and who says to each one of us, I am at your side. Trust in me. I will neither forget you nor abandon you. Can we hear him whispering to us, I am with you always. I accompany you. I strengthen you, for I am your Lord and God, and I uphold you with my victorious right hand. You are precious and valuable to me. Will this God forget or abandon us, my dear brothers and sisters? Never. He, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, loved us so much and accepted all sufferings and death on the cross for our sake. Do our whole being thirst and long for Him? Our Lord and Savior, the Lord of our life, wants and longs to make His home in us, and that is explicitly expressed in the book of Revelation, chapter 3, verse 20. Listen, I'm standing at the door knocking. If you hear my voice and open the door, I will come into you and eat with you, and you with me. He is a God who keeps knocking at the door of our hearts to enter in and waits with eager longing to dine with us in order to celebrate the joy of being together. My dear brothers and sisters, how long are we going to be deaf to His invitation and keep the doors of our hearts shut? And how long are we going to live in anger, jealousy, pride, selfishness, worry, anxiety, and reject the love of our loving Savior? Today, shall we surrender our whole being at His most holy feet and beg pardon for our faults and failures and ask Him to take possession of our lives? Shall we also ask Him earnestly to envelop and cover us with His most glorious presence and grace? He with us and we in Him. What a celestial union to cherish and enjoy, my dear people. We read in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 3, verse 16, about the unconditional and self-sacrificing love of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, so that everyone who believes in Him may not perish but may have eternal life. What are we going to offer to this ever-abiding love of the Lord? Shall we, along with the psalmist, tell the Lord the verses 1 and 2 of Psalm 42 and express our sincere longing for Him? As a deer longs for flowing streams, so my soul longs for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When shall I come and behold the face of God? When we speak these words from the depth of our being to the Lord, heaven rejoices, my dear people, because He longs for our love and intimacy. Our loving Savior, Jesus Christ, is a God of compassion and mercy. He is a God who felt compassion for the multitude and satisfied their needs. He is a God who healed the sick. He is a God who blessed the little children. He is a God who raised the dead to life. He is a God who calmed the wind and storm and gave confidence to the disciples who were dying of fear. He is a God who invited the Samaritan woman to worship Him in spirit and truth. This same God, our Lord Jesus Christ, who blessed all those who were in need, continues to be with us, blesses us with countless blessings even today because we are close to Him and we call upon Him and seek His face always. This Lord God, who led the people of Israel in the pillar of cloud by day and in the pillar of fire by night, certainly will lead us during all the troubles of life and will accompany us in the journey of life and take us one day to His heavenly kingdom. To Him be the glory forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. Come, let us pray. God of our life, gracious and merciful God, Jesus Christ, our beloved Lord and Savior, Holy Spirit, our advocate and counselor, we come to your throne of grace and mercy with heart full of love and gratitude for your tender, compassionate and merciful love. Jesus, our beloved Lord, we cannot live in this world without praising you, worshipping you, adoring you, for all glory, honor and greatness belong to you alone, Lord. You, O Lord, are a God of promises, and you promise never to forget us, and that you have carved us on the palm of your hands. Here we are, loving Lord, at your most holy feet, most holy presence, seeking and asking for the gifts and fruits of your Spirit. Fill us, Lord, with your life-giving water and anoint us with the power of the Holy Spirit. We look up to you, gaze at you, sweet and loving Savior. Gracious Lord, we want to live like you in tenderness, kindness, compassion, love and selflessness, and make your life-giving words the program of our life. Father, turn your merciful and gentle eyes towards your children who live in pain, sin, anxiety, fear of pandemic, and those who are caught up in the clutches of devil. Extend, Lord, your healing and compassionate hands upon each of them and relieve them of all their problems and transform them into a new creation. Meet all their needs, loving Redeemer. Let your children live in good health of body, mind and spirit. Remember, most loving Father, all the poor, abandoned, slum dwellers, orphans and those who are left alone in hospitals and homes. May your gentle presence comfort and bring solace to them, Lord. Let the whole world accept you as their only Savior and Lord and proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. All glory, honor and power belong to you, our Lord and God. We make this prayer in your most holy name, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
I will never forget you, my people. I have carved you on the palm of my hands. I will never forget you. I will not leave you often. I will never forget my word. Does a mother forget her baby, or a woman the child within her womb? Yet even if this forget, yes, even if this forget, I will never.